We often hear that trees can communicate with another and organisms in their environment. Some would even say that trees possess intelligence. I am Nicole van Dam, professor of Molecular Interaction Ecology, and I will explain whether trees talk to each other or not, and what evolutionary advantage that might have. It's true. Trees can communicate with each other. In fact, it's essential for them to do so. For example, if a tree is attacked by herbivores, like caterpillars, it can warn predators, like insect-eating birds, to help. Other trees can pick up these signals too. But how exactly does the tree do this? My team and I have discovered that trees communicate among each other via volatile compounds that they emit in the air. When a caterpillar feeds on a leaf, the tree produces a specific bouquet of volatiles. Other trees, and also birds and parasitic wasps, can perceive these volatiles and respond accordingly. In order to tap into tree communication, our scientists use a 35-meter-high canopy crane. This allows them to work in the canopies of mature trees. The scientist went up to spray some branches with a natural plant hormone. After this, the tree branch emits volatiles as if they were a caterpillar feeding. They also attached fake caterpillars made of green clay to treated and untreated branches. Predators, such as birds, that are attracted by the volatiles, assume this is a real caterpillar and take a bite. This leaves a typical mark in the clay, which can be counted as numbers of attacks. The results? Many more birds try to peck at the fake caterpillars on branches emitting more volatiles due to the hormone treatment. This shows that trees indeed can signal to attract bodyguards, like birds that remove caterpillars. You could consider this a form of communication, even though trees use volatile substances instead of language. I would certainly call this a clever strategy. But trees cannot consciously decide what they say, when, and to whom. We have no evidence that they are as intelligent as humans. Nevertheless, trees certainly deserve our respect and protection, if only because they are home to much of the biodiversity of insects and birds on Earth.